Welcome back. Still to come this morning, Raj will be taking your calls on when good kids go bad. Are you worried that your kids are straying from the straight and narrow? Have you had to deal with a teenage tearaway? Do you think that tough love is the answer? Call us now on 0870 1101 101. That's 0870 1101 101.
Brian Capron's going to be here any minute now because we are harbouring the killer that everyone is looking for.
No one knows he's here.
But before that, yes, we know. Shh, don't tell anyone. Time now, though, for a little indulgence with day two of Luxury Week. Now then, the French capital, Paris, is famous for two things, love and shopping. We sent the man who loves to shop, get it? John Scott, for a weekend of retail therapy. And keep watching because you could win the chance to do the same.
Now then, did you see Coronation Street last night? Is there nothing killer Richard Hillman won't do as Weatherfield police take poor innocent Ashley into custody? We are harbouring the man himself.
I don't think I should move in just yet. I think we should wait.
That's fair enough.
I think we should wait until we get married.
You had a chance and you blew it.
Oh, come on, Richard! Please, we can't leave...
In case I don't bump into you again, have a happy new year. Let's hope next year's as eventful as the last one.
And in true form, he sat watching that and he laughed. You laughed.
Well, it is quite funny, isn't it, really?
Well, it depends what size of fence you're on, doesn't it? Brian Capron, lovely to see you again.
Oh, it's nice to be here.
It was gripping last night. Absolutely gripping.
Yeah, the writers have come up with some storming stuff. I must say, I just saw the second part last night because I was a bit late getting down to London, but I thought I was really horrible.
You
it was really horrible. But it was quite a gripping episode.
Do you know how many people watched that second episode?
No.
We've got a bit of a surprise for you. You peaked last night at 17 million viewers.
Wow.
And that is, I mean, I think the average is 10, 11, 12.
It doesn't really happen that much on telly these days, you know, because so many things to watch, and it's extraordinary.
Yes,
it's like the old days of TV viewers.
I think it's because it's been a slow-developing story, which kind of reflects what's been happening on Corrie, you know, because it's been a slow burn and little bits keep coming out and it builds and builds and builds, you know. And so it's just really nice, you know, to be part of it, I must say.
So preparing for that day's recording, when you get the old Jemmy and you're in poor old Aide's coat, the famous leather gloves and the hat and everything, and you've got to stick it on her head.
Yeah.
That must have been actually quite difficult to psych yourself up for, or was it just hilarious?
No, I think the final bit where I crawled up behind Emily was quite horrible because I actually had we had some lightweight crowbars. We had three to choose from, but I actually chose to use the heavy one for that moment. Mm. And as I crawled up behind her, crept up behind her, Eileen just kind of ducked down like that, and I really whacked the actual sofa, of course, you know, with the weight of it. And so it was quite horrible.
Mm.
And just looking at poor old Eileen lying like that, and she had this kind of, you know, sort of false piece on here, you know, but it looked horrible, like a bit of brain showing through.
But it was your reaction as well when you went... awful.
Yeah, I think that's kind of Richard's conscience and doesn't...
If she survives that, she's gone. Yeah. That's a thick head, isn't it?
Yes, she must be one of the first people on Earth to survive. Well,
you see, I was trying to work it out. I was getting into Richard's brain and thinking that Richard was nervous, so he only managed the glancing blow. But then,
of course,
when Maxine came in, you were fired up and terrified because she'd seen you.
Yes,
so
absolutely.
She got the big battering.
I think that's one of my favourite lines, actually, and I wanted to do it slightly different, but I couldn't, you know, which you should have stayed at the party, Maxine, because I'd love to have gone... You should have stayed at the party, Maxine. You know, because that's just a great line.
Here's Nicky.
Yeah, it's like that, isn't it? Yeah. But in effect, they only they re-edited the show on Friday night and only finished it. We weren't sure the balance, didn't want to make it too brutal, although, in fact, all the compliance authorities agreed. Originally, I hit her four times.
Yeah.
And they've cut it back to one in order that they could use the meat shot afterwards and not make too much of it. But I think the balance was good because I don't think it was that gruesome. Mm-hmm. I think that my feeling was it was the preamble to it and the aftermath, which was as interesting or more interesting than the actual killings themselves.
My heart was beating fast watching you crowbarring the door and poor old Emily scaring herself with a film. And like you do when you're watching a scary film going...
Yeah,
and we love the glasses. Her glasses falling off the arm. We're not sure that was intentional, but when the glasses fell off the arm of the chair,
when the bodies were discovered.
You weren't there then, of course.
No,
you were in the pub on the road going, "Oh dear, what's happening? You beast!"
The bit that worried me more than anything was when I broke through the fence and I put this perfect piece back.
Yeah. I thought that was marvellous.
I thought you were going to vault it. But if he goes over that, then I'm impressed.
So you crushed up the barbiturates into the drink that you gave to Aidan.
Yes.
So, but presumably it's still in his blood somewhere, isn't it? The bottle isn't there.
Well,
my forensic.
Who knows? That's very good. Yes, that could be quite instrumental later on.
Ah.
Good,
because he's hidden it in the you saw.
I did.
Also, I mean, Aid's drunk, isn't he? And perhaps Peter Barlow's seen him walking towards that fence and probably doesn't look that drunk, Richard, did he just walk towards the fence? I don't know if that's maybe something, because I haven't seen the scripts, but that's what I kind of thought, you know.
Brian, you've given us much more to think about now.
Who knows?
It's lovely to see you, and my goodness, it was cracking last night. There's what's today, Tuesday?
Yep.
The next episode's tomorrow, then.
Yeah, and I think the aftermath and the fallout is very good.
Excellent.
His conscience.
Can't wait. Thank you very much indeed.
It's a
lovely
pleasure.
To see you.
Yeah, there's a couple of police officers outside who want a word with you, actually.
Yes.
Just standing in the
corridor.
We'll
harbour him.
You're safe in here for the time being.
Oh, dear. Anyway, still to come this Tuesday morning, it's all about water babies when we turn our attention to the smallest members of your family in our new series, Little Cherubs. That's all.